The topic for this video is the constitution and bylaws of any NGO. So what is meant by constitution of an NGO? A constitution is a brief statement setting forth the general organization of an agency without giving the details of procedures to be followed which are contained in the bylaws. The objects of an organization are broadly classified in or broadly indicated in the constitution. So constitution is just a brief statement and it does not include the detailed rules and regulations and other details which are usually included in the bylaws. So it is just a broad indication of the objects of the organization. So this includes the duties, powers and functions of the various limbs of the organization, the details of the board of directors, the details of the office bearers, the elections, then the subcommittees, the meetings, the official year, the amendments to the constitution, the details of the finances, maintenance and operation of bank accounts, the assets of the NGO and the process of dissolution of the NGO. So these are some of the important of the broad details which should be included in the constitution of the NGO. Now let us have a look at what should be included in the bylaws. So bylaws are nothing but the detailed rules and regulations governing the day-to-day working of an agency. So the rules and regulations will usually include the following. The first is the membership requirements, which may be a membership fee, that is the financial provision of paying a certain amount to the agency regularly. There may be different types of membership depending on the amount of money you contribute, such as ordinary members, life members, special members, contributing members, etc. Next is the minimum age limit for the membership of the general body and the executive body. So secondly, a minimum age limit may be fixed for the membership, which may be separate for the general body and different again for the executive body. Then the third requirement for membership may be a special interest of a member in the agency's program. Then the next point which is included in the bylaws is the tenure and manner of cessation of membership. Then the meeting clause is included, the governing body clause including their composition and power, the chief executive, every staff member of the agency and the members of the board must have copies of the constitution and bylaws for ready reference. So this is about the constitution and bylaws, and these are the references which may be referred.